Howdy, bubs, and welcome back. Today we're going to be doing three small segments put together to create one short video to address how to make a custom cursor, how to add a hit spark for whenever your projectile impacts a wall, and then finally to have a little dust effect whenever your character lands. Earlier I created three sprites just to save ourselves some time. First, something for my cursor. I'm just using a simple crosshair. Next, I have a sprite for my projectile, my arrow, hitting into a wall and then breaking apart and then landing on whatever it impacted. And then finally, for the dust, it's a single little poof of dust and it slowly goes away. First, with our cursor, let's go ahead and go into our O game. And right now, we don't have anything really in here, and in our create event we're just going to add in two lines. And so this sets up game, and our lines are simply specifying what is the cursor sprite, and this is going to be equal to, in my case, s cursor. Don't know why I named it with an underscore. Let me fix that. S cursor. What this actually does is where we have our cursor, it will draw the sprite. However, it still draws the default cursor there. We don't want the default cursor anymore. So I'm going to go ahead and do window_set_cursor. And I'm going to specify what I'm sending it to. There's actually a small list of different default cursor icons that you can use. This specifies we're going to use none of those, and instead we're just going to use a custom cursor. This can be very useful if you set up certain conditionals, so that way if you're doing certain things, you swap what your cursor is. Right now I'm just going to leave it as this as a default. So now whenever we run our program, we see here I have a crosshair rather than the default cursor. And that's all you need for the cursor. The next component we're going to address is creating the hit spark. So this is going to address our projectile making impact with a wall. So of course we're going to have to go to our projectile object and add in a new event for post draw. And so this will draw our projectile before wall collision. Otherwise, you'll get a situation where it will swap to the collision sprite a step before it should have. With this, we'll ensure we still have the projectile going on before we swap over to our collision sprite, which is the hit spark. So, if replace meeting X and Y impacts, in our case, a wall. If you have multiple wall-like objects, you might have to add in more lines here, or at least more checks. But if, in my case, I impact with a wall, I'm going to go ahead and instance_change. I'm going to change what my object is. This projectile is going to turn into a O hit spark. But of course, I don't have a hit spark right now, so it's not going to fill in, and I'm going to say true. Of course, we have to create a hit spark for this line to work. So I'm going to create a new object, O hit spark. And in here, we're going to go ahead and just specify our create event. And because we've changed the instance rather than create something new and whatnot, it actually inherits all of the values, properties of the previous object. And so this is going to set a couple of variables. I want to make sure my speed is set to 0. Otherwise, our projectile will keep flying. I'm also going to create a new event for animation end. In here, I specify what we want to happen after we complete the animation. In this case, destroy object. Now, you don't need this. Maybe you want to keep, in my case, the arrows stuck into the wall wherever it landed. It's up to you. I'm personally just going to remove them from the game. I might revisit this topic later. But in my case, I'm going to do instance underscore destroy, and it'll just be removed. Now let's go ahead and make sure we select our sprite, S hit spark, and go ahead and jump into this. Now whenever I fire my crossbow and I make impact with the wall, you see it starts breaking. Now you can see it's kind of having certain weird collisions depending on the parts where it makes contact. We can mess around with the collision mask to try to improve that. Let's go ahead and jump into our projectile and look at the collision mask. It's kind of larger than we'd need. I'm going to make this manual, and I only want to check for collisions really in this little central area. And then try that again and see if it has a better impact. There we go, it appears much better than before. But now we have a nice little animation to happen anytime we hit a wall. Finally, the last thing we're going to be looking at is how we're going to go ahead and create a dust effect anytime that we land, or depending on what you're doing, want to create some type of particle effect. First off, we're going to create a new object. In my case, I'm going to call it ODust. And make sure I specify our dust sprite. And we're going to have three events. First, a create event. This will simply address randomizing values. And in here, I'm going to set the image speed to be a random range between 0.5 and 1. I'm going to set the image index to be a random range from 3 to 6. And then I'm going to set my horizontal speed to be equal to a random range from negative 2 to 2. And following this same pattern, we're going to create a variable for vertical speed. That ranges from negative 2 to 2. And then finally, image x scale is going to choose either negative 1 or positive 1. And the same thing for the y scale. So what are we doing here exactly? Well, first I'm specifying how fast is this image going to be moving. I set it between 0.5 and 1. That way we can get a slight difference between each of these, because this is just for one dust particle. Whenever we write the script in a moment, we're actually going to create multiple dust particles. This time, every time a dust particle is created, there's something different about it. It cycles through the frames faster. It starts at a different index. It moves left or right. It moves up or down. And it could be flipped across the X axis or across the Y axis. This will allow us to have a decent variety despite having only one sprite here. So with all of this set up, we can go into our step event and define how we're moving. Move or slow down. And so our x value is going to be modified by our horizontal speed, our y value is going to be modified by our vertical speed, and our horizontal speed is going to be reduced by 10% by multiplying it by 90%, 0.9. And we're going to do the same thing with our vertical speed. That way, we're moving the appropriate directions, and we are then reducing the speed at which we are moving. And finally, we're going to go ahead and set in the animation end clean up. The dust particle eventually vanishes. And so this is instance destroy. So now, as soon as the dust particle has finished its final step, it'll then destroy itself. But all this does is create for us a single dust particle. We also need to address the script that will actually handle the code for this. So we're going to go ahead and create a new script. And this will be make dust. In here we want to specify the amount, how much dust we want, and then whether it's going to be moving in the x direction or the y direction. We're going to repeat for this amount. This will specify how many dust particles we're going to create. And inside here, with this specific dust particle, instance underscore create layer at this x position, and the bottom of whatever is calling this. So in this case, if it is our player, it's the bottom of the player. That is the y position we're using. In our current layer, we're going to create our O dust object. So if our value for xCloud is not true, so false, this will make sure we set our horizontal speed to be equal to zero. We don't want it to move in the x direction. Then if our y cloud value is not true, false, our vertical speed is set to zero. This will just allow us to, when we call this function, specify, okay, I want 30 dust particles and I want it to be true, false. What this means is that we will not move in the y direction. There's going to be no dust particles moving up and down. They'll only be moving left to right, because we set this to true. You can set them both to true, and it'll create just a circle that pops out. Now that we have the script set up, we simply go over to our move script, and inside here, I want to find whenever I am jumping. So if I'm not on the floor, okay. So if I'm not on the floor, this is whenever we're in the air. Over here, this is whenever we're actually checking that we have now landed. So right after we land, we switch over to our walk or idle, but I want to, right before we do that, once we've set image speed back to 1, actually it doesn't really matter, we can then immediately check for landing making dust if the sprite index was equal to s jump, s player jump in my case, then, so this just tells us, okay, we were jumping a moment ago, we're now switching to something else. Before we switch, I want to make dust, and I'm going to make 30 particles of dust, and I want it to move in the x direction, but not the y direction. Now let's go ahead and run this and see if we can make some dust whenever we land. And there we go. Whenever I land, you see a little bit of dust pop up below me. Now, if I had a different color background, it'd be a little bit more distinct. But now I have a little bit of dust anytime I land. But this is how you can implement dust and very simple particle effects. You can use this same concept, mess around with it, change it up, so that way you can have other particle effects in your game. Maybe you want a particle effect whenever your projectile impacts the wall. Not just switching sprites, but also perhaps swapping out and having a little bit of dust occur whenever it makes contact. But that's all I've got for this one. If you have any questions or need any assistance, just let me know in class. Otherwise, everyone, have a good one. I just wanted to say thank you to all of my Patreon supporters. Shout out to my bad bubs, my top five, my day ones. Y'all have always been there for me. Next up, my baby bubs, the next five. I always love y'all's support. And finally, for everyone else, any little bit helps. Thank you to all my basic bubs for supporting me along my journey. If you want to continue receiving notifications, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and don't forget to hit that bell button.